Que no tan mun yap son nou. Yo kembe o pala ke nou. Si kompasa se pou nou. Men yo men ki kwe nan nou. Yo te rete la, chik nou rive la. Aktivite se yo pa tap tan. Kole ou ban, pa kole ou ban. Pa plini ou ki pou sobe.
Mesdames et messieurs, bonsoir et bienvenue encore une fois à l'autre édition de Spotlight Creole. Comme nous toujours dit, Spotlight Creole, c'est remis sur le déraciné de tout artiste haïtien qui vit dans la communauté. Nous. Il travaille, monsieur et mesdames, artistes haïtiens, ça vous fait.
G5 sitting on the runway. Big ass chopper, call that bitch Beyonce. This for my dogs locked down all day. Money, power, respect, free the hard way. I put some real niggas on their feet, boy. So they'll kill anyone for me, boy. Yeah. YMCMB, boy. Young, put your fresh to death. Rest in peace, boy. My gap bang your hat hang. I ride off with Mac Man. I drink Patron straight. You niggas keep that champagne. My paw is the Birdman. I'm rich as a white man. I come to your show and kill you and your hype man. We rolling, let's roll out.
HALLAN, DAPHNIS, in the morning. Thank you very much for waking up with us as far as this program is concerned. And today I do have another associate of mine. We've done radio and television in the past. And currently the brother, you know, is residing in California, but we're trying to get him to come back down here on this side of town so we can do some wonderful work together here on the network. I am talking about the one and only Melo Gelo, better known as Mr. Eugel Nicoleau.
What's pleasure, HALLAN. It's always a pleasure getting together with you. And it's a pleasure getting back here in Southern California. I see that our community is really pushing up and building up a lot of the professional semi-pro, and I see you still kicking more and more today by God's grace, and it's a pleasure to be here with you.
Definitely, man, something that's really wonderful to do. But you know a lot about the history of Miami, because when I came from Boston, Massachusetts, back in 1980, as I can recollect, you were still here. Yes. You know, in Miami, and so much has changed. Take us back a little bit, very quickly, and how much do you see that Miami or the Haitian American community has changed?
Man, by God's grace, I came in August 1972 from New York, and from what I've seen around, man, I am amazed and very surprised to see how the Haitian community have grown. Mm-hmm. You know, and a lot of stuff that's happening in Little Haiti, mm-hmm. as we speak, mm-hmm. it is amazing. The high-rise building, from what we know from 1972 to 2012, it has been a tremendous change in Little Haiti.
That's right. There was like a great influx, you know, of the boat people, the refugees coming in, you know, from Haiti, trying to flee, you know, Duvalier regime, or so forth, and so on. And at that time, you, along with so many others, were still very much active in trying to bring out positive changes as far as the Miami Haitian community is concerned. Now, of course, you've seen some major changes. When you came down, what was it that really struck you the most? You talked about the high rises in terms of how the community is growing. What are you most pleased with right now, would you say?
Well, what I'm most pleased with, it's a lot of the young generation that I left when I came, okay. came here in 72. These guys have grown, they've gone to school and gotten, you know, their degrees and stuff, and they have built the community. Okay. You know, they not only in educate God first, you know, a lot of the churches and all that, but education-wise,
okay.
they became the us of yesterday,
okay.
you know,
okay.
and they're into politics. We have a lot of the Haitians that are head chief of police in North Miami, and which I am very, you know, blessed to hear. And I met another friend that was a major, and we know, as we know from way back, Eugene Gary,
exactly,
that became the
exactly.
commander, and it's a big change. It's a total change. It's like a new Miami, Florida.
All right. You were always in the mix as far as the melange, dealing with the various ethnic groups here in South Florida, something that you're still doing. In the past, it was somewhat difficult, you know, for the Haitians to intermingle with the other nationalities, you know, back in the early, you know, 80s. Do you see that this has changed somewhat? There's a better relationship right now with these groups?
It has changed a whole lot. Okay. And I am very pleased to see that we are as brothers and sisters in our community, because the Haitian community have grown so much here. That's why in my feelings, my sense, mm-hmm. that's why I'm back in the community, because I am very surprised to see how we have grown in Miami, the way we interact with the different cultures, and it's no longer, oh, you guys are Haitians, you're on this side, and we're on that side. Everybody's together, and I am very pleased to see how we have grown in Miami, in Southern, you know, the South, because I'm from the West Coast right now, so it is a pleasure to see, and it's a blessing to see how we have grown in our community.
All right. Now, the entire East Coast, many Haitian Americans, you know, residing in Boston, New Jersey, Connecticut, you know, Philadelphia, so forth and so on. Now, the fact that you are in California, how is the Haitian American community there? How much have they grown? What do they need to work upon? And how do you see the future of that community over there in California?
That community in Cali, it needs to be, you know, it needs to be worked on, because California is so large, it's big, so they're spread out. It's over 75,000. Close to 75,000 Haitians in California, but okay. The thing is, 25% are professional, so they're so spread out. So we need to get, like, for instance, when a band comes from here or from Haiti to perform, you have to do the email. But here in the community, radio, television, like your program on TV, it not only educate, it enlightens our community, and then you're able to go places, different places. In California, it's more of an email thing, and those that are close to each other, they're working all the time. For any event, you have to, like, let them know 2-3 months in advance. Here in Miami, you know, a radio program or a television program, 1, 2, 3, it happens.
Well, this is why I am so much happy to be involved with this particular channel, Diaspo TV, but as you know, BWAT, we bring in from IET at least 15 different television stations, something that we were unable to do. But now people are having access to Haitians throughout the diaspora, and I think that is a wonderful thing. Now, something else that you don't know about Melo Gelo, because that's what I call the brother, is also a very good singer, a very good entertainer, because when I met Melo Gelo, he was singing solo, done some gig with Voila, you know, Lucky Pierre, just to name a few. Now, what prompted you to get into the music business anyway?
Well, I grew up singing in church ever since I was a kid at 5 years old in Haiti. Mm-hmm. Ebenezer Seventh-day Adventist Church. And as I got older, my parents didn't want me to get into the secular business.
Okay.
So as I got older, I got into, you know, the business. And being talented, God has blessed me with a talent. So it's always been a love for God, a love for music, a love for my people.
Okay.
You know, wherever I go, hey, it's always, hey, I'm 110% or 150% Haitian. So I always wanted for people to know that there's good in us.
That's
in
right.
Haiti, we have a rich culture, and it's been a blessing. It was a blessing from birth, and it's still a blessing as I got older.
That's right. Now, your brother was to really pull out a serious pipe.
Oh, yeah, that's a definite.
As far as your ability to sing, and you have had the chance to work with guys like Dado Basket as well, Ali Creed, that you've done some work.
Oh, yeah, Ali LeCon, Pierre LeBlanc,
yes.
You know, Jeff Calloway. So it's been a blessing, and like I said, I'm a team player. I'm not here to try to boast or overdo it. It's a blessing that God has given me, and I want to use it not only for the advancement of his kingdom, but to let people know that there's good in us. You know, God has talents in every single one of us, and we need to put it to you.
Now, are we going to have an opportunity to hear from you in the future? Is it something that you more or less neglected this somewhat? Because I haven't heard anything about you as far as appearing on a particular album as a guest. Are you working on something, or are you just taking it more or less easy right now?
Oh, no, I've been doing a lot of work at my church at Breath of Life and Seventh-day Adventist Church, and Inglewood, California. And since I'm here, I've gotten together with Aguilar Corn, Fafa Etienne, and I've been talking to Dadu. Tico comes by, Tico Pasquet come by a whole lot. And we're putting something together. So as soon as it's still in the pot, it's boiling, it's cooking. All so right. Soon, very soon, we'll be coming out with something very nice. And, you know, give back to our community, you know?
All right. Now, earlier, I did mention that we're trying to do our very best for Melo Gelo to be a part of what we're doing here on Diaspo TV. Now, we have had a chance to discuss that. We've done some work before in the past. But you did mention that you have a program in mind. And I believe you mentioned earlier Hearts for Haiti.
Right. That's a definite Hearts okay. for Haiti.
Now, why Hearts for Haiti? Why such a name, and what does it mean to you?
Hearts for Haiti is a program and a nonprofit that we started in California because we have seen after the earthquake, everybody have collected money and nothing has done for our country. Okay. So myself and a friend of mine called Windsor, okay. He's in California. He's a multicultural dude, you know, and we started. We said, let's do a fundraiser to help Haiti. Okay. So with Loma Linda University and Loma Linda Hospital, it's the Seventh-day Adventist Hospital in California. So we started putting our ideas together, and okay. we came up with the name Hearts for Haiti. People that are concerned, that we see that we are hurting, even though we're in America, because of our people suffering in Haiti. So we started with Hearts for Haiti, and to back that up with concerned Haitians. All of the Haitians that are concerned, we want them to join it with Hearts for Haiti to help our people in Haiti.
Do you believe or have you found that the people have been responding thus far? And since the earthquake, what have you guys done to show your participation in the rebuilding process?
Oh yeah, with Hearts for Haiti, we have done about 4 or 5 trips to Haiti. We have sent a lot of stuff, okay. clothing, medical supplies, food and all that, and I have teamed up with 2 or 3 other nonprofit organizations which goes back and forth to Haiti as we speak. They are in Haiti, and Dr. Nelson Scott,
okay,
he goes back to Zikini, is the Seventh-day Adventist Hospital in Haiti.
All right.
And also Dr. Daniel, he's the assistant chief okay. at a medical clinic in Los Angeles. We all have teamed together with T. George Chicken, which is a Haitian guy that has a Haitian restaurant in okay. California. So right. we've teamed up with a lot of different professionals just to help out, to lend a helping hand. That's what we're asking for everybody here in Miami, man. This is where our hearts are. This is where I started out at, you know, as a youngster. And with you, Alan Daphnis, and I know your heart has always been for the Haitian community, and that's what we're doing. We're putting it Definitely. Together to help our people in Haiti. That's why we call it Hearts for Haiti and Concerned Haitians.
All right, many of us are concerned, but my director, Alex Calix, mentioned to me earlier, he heard on the radio, well, some people are not really pleased of the fact that, you know, Haiti is not really getting the major help that it was supposed to be getting. As far as the rebuilding process, money that was being allocated is not being distributed allegedly properly, so we don't have the facts to back that up. So if you feel that type of press or negative press, will it have an impact as far as you know, your fundraising process and to get people involved? Because if they're not getting the funds to do the work, some may be somewhat reluctant to come out and still participate in the rebuilding process. And
the whole thing is that we have everything on paper.
Okay.
We are legal. We have our 501c. So everything is there. We are in open book. So whatever they want to see, and we have a book that was dedicated, that was made from the setting in Haiti. The okay. different doctors, the different lawyers, the different nurses, and all the different groups that had to help.
Okay.
It's the whole book. It says Haiti, and it's a Seventh-day Adventist hospital in Haiti, Zikini. That's who we're helping. And when I come back again from California, I will bring you a copy of it. Then we can show around that these people will see that it is work being done.
Mm-hmm.
That we should say in the background, because mm-hmm. a lot of people have collected. I've okay. been at the First AME Church in Southern California. I was sitting next to the president of Red Cross. They handed him a check for $1 million, and nothing has been done for Haiti. That's how we started Hearts for Haiti and Concerned Haitians.
That's right. Well, we are definitely concerned, and we'll continue to have a say-so in the matter. Now, when we did the radio program on WPBR Radio Galaxy several years ago, you talked about, you know, Barack Obama being the next elected president of the United States. You saw it ahead of time. It actually happened.
Yes.
Now,
yes,
just for the record, are you pleased somewhat with how, you know, you feel it is running the country right now?
I am very well pleased with the way our president is running the country. Even though people are saying this and that and the negativity, he has been doing a whole lot.
Okay.
It's so much that you could do when your hand is tied up, mm-hmm. that you're doing so much. First of all, once you do the statistic, he's one of the best president that has helped with health. His wife is working, making sure that the kids are, the diets for these high school kids, junior high school kids, are properly set. Mm-hmm. You know, so he's been doing a pretty good job, even though you hear the negativity. Well, they've talked bad about Jesus Christ.
Okay.
So the brothers, you know, he's very positive, but we just got to keep helping him. Us as the Haitian community, we got to back him up regardless what you hear in the media. We still got to back him up.
All right. A lot of people are still talking about the economy. They want for it to get better, and hopefully it will.
Okay.
Now, do you believe, I'm going to give you an opportunity to make another prediction. Do you believe that our current president will be reelected?
That's a definite. 110% he will win, as long as we keep hope alive, we keep the dream going. He will be the next president again. He will win the second term.
Now, since we're still on the subject of president, someone that you know very well, you know, Sweet Mickey, but we're not calling him Sweet Mickey now,
Michel Martelly.
Who is our current president, you know, in Haiti. You know the man, he's a musician. I believe he has a very tough job. Now, he's trying his very best to move the country forward. Are you pleased thus far with the work that he's doing?
This far, I am very pleased.
Mm-hmm.
Same thing with when we talk about President Obama. The man has a job to do. He doesn't have all the tools. He doesn't have all the means for the job. But so far, so good. He's working to better the country, to better our people. And we've seen and heard on radio and seen on television how he gets up at 2, 3 o'clock in the morning, tell these guys, come on, let's go. We got to go clean the streets.
Well,
you know? So it's something that, and even though you hear that he's a musician, he's this, it's so much that you can do, so much that you have to work with.
Okay.
If you have the means and the tool, uh-huh. yes, you're going to do a wonderful job. But as long as your hands tied up, it's so much that you could do, so much that he could do, even though it's always like that in the past and in the future. When God's time, they talked about him doing this and doing that. The man is going to be doing, he's trying to do a good job. As long as we allow him to stay focused, to do what he has to do, he will do a good job in Haiti.
And you don't think there'll be a coup d'etat?
Oh, they have said they have tried. They have tried a couple weeks ago, but
okay.
by God's grace, and he's a very wise person.
Uh-huh.
It didn't happen, but we need to put our heads together. Same way that the song that we did with Yassa Massa, vraiment ou pas gagne chance, pourtant on sait un paradis, depuis longtemps on a souffri. You know, we have to put our heads together. We have to have that togetherness, the love for our country, the love for the president that's there. Then we'll see how the country, how we'll go about doing things in Haiti the more that we work with President
Michel
Martelly.
Well, for sure, I don't believe there'll be a coup, and I think Michel will do his very best to propel the country, you know, to a very positive level. And, you know, as a Haitian-American, that's what we want to see, a better future for the children of Haiti, because they are the ones who are going to represent the country in the future. Melo, as Eugel Nicoleau, so much to talk about. I am looking forward to that program, Hearts for Haiti, on Diaspo TV. I think it's going to be a great show.
Yes,
thank you for taking the time out to talk to me.
It's always a pleasure, Alan. Always a pleasure, man. I'm happy to be back home, and let's move on for the betterment of Haiti, man, you know?
That's
Hearts
right.
for Haiti concerning Haitians and people of Miami. I'm looking forward to doing some work with you guys, especially my... First of all, I need to tell you guys before we get off, this is my mentor, Alan Daphnis. He doesn't like for me to say that, but I have learned a whole lot from Alan Daphnis. And it's not only myself, but most of the different Haitian programs and the television program have started with Alan Daphnis.
Well, thank you very much, brother. Appreciate that. And looking forward to watch you at work on May 19th over at Chef Creole Seafood, corner 54th Street
and Northwest 2nd Avenue.
That's right, Northwest 2nd Avenue. It's been fun. Alex, take us home, man. Thanks a lot.
G5 sitting on the runway. Big ass chopper, call that bitch Beyonce. This for my dogs locked down all day. Money, power, respect, free the hard way. I put some real niggas on their feet, boy. So they'll kill anyone for me, boy. Yeah, YMCMB, boy. Young Tunchi, fresh to death, rest in peace, boy. My gap bang your hat hang, I ride off with Mac, man. I drink Patron straight, you niggas keep that champagne. My paw is the bird, man, I'm rich as a white man. I come to your show and kill you and your hype, man. We rollin', let's roll out, my bitches don't hold out. They got Marley G, I gotta buy my little bro out. Let my dreads grow out, my bitch got a blowout. Mi casa, su casa, my house is a whole house. Only fuck with real niggas. Polo, fuck that heel figure. Yeah, I'm on the pill, nigga. Feed you to my little niggas. Shout out to my big homies, Fifi and T Streets. Scope on that AK. Make me take a sneak peek. T, roll another one. Razor blade under tongue. You ain't never seen this watch, nigga. This one of one. You niggas is honey bun. Your girlfriend a ton of fun. Chopper with a drum. Motherfucker, get a drum or something. Blunt back like my blunt of thumb. Suck a nigga, dig it some. Pop that pussy for me, then while I didn't give my niggas some, I'ma do my thing, I put that on Nicki Minaj. I need a bad red bone to come give my dick a massage. I'm talking big money, I'm talking heavyweight. I cut down on the surge, now I'm in better shape. I'm from New Orleans, nigga, where you ain't ever safe. Who fuck with me?